Now, week two of high school football includes some pretty great matches, including a powerhouse showdown between Lompoc and Bishop Diego. It's been a very long time since these two have been able to play each other. KSBY's Dustin Kleeman is live in Santa Barbara right now with our game of the week. Dustin.
Good evening, Jessica. The Cards and the Braves, they battled it out tonight. And it was a non-league game that was supposed to bring highlights galore. Well, there were some. It was a late bloomer of a game, but there was a lot of emotion on both sides of the football field tonight for different reasons, facing challenges and tragedy.
The handshake of two Titan teams facing off for the first time ever, a non-league game, both teams looking to bounce back, and it was all about establishing a strong ground game. This time with converted wide receiver LeAndre Coleman, only a junior and a speedster on the corners. He'd help the Braves march down the field, and you know what, in the very next play, pay that man his money. They would get into the end zone untouched. Braves miss the extra point, but add a field goal to end the half 9-3. To the second, in the first play for the Braves, you know it's perfectly executed play action pass when you fake out the cameraman, but a deep strike to Ryan Morgan as he fights his way in for 16-3 Braves. Next drive, the momentum carrying through on D. Junior Nick Dominguez with the solid pick. He would return it just a few yards, and that would set up this absolute brilliant scamper. The quarterback, Cameron Abarin, taking it for himself. The hustle, the need for speed. He'd sneak in. He makes it 24-3. The Braves absolutely rolling, and it was part of a refocused effort on offense. And who else to bury the Cards? It's LeAndre Coleman, and it's the show everyone's tuning into. 50 yards, the man running with emotion after the death of his friend, Ty Bartley.
It meant a lot, you know, over the past weekend, losing a friend, important person to me, and just coming out here, remember his name, had his funeral today, just something to play for besides my teammates.
We had to get back to our run game. We struggled, you know, last week. We knew they were going to bring the heat on us because of all the struggles we had last week. I thought our guys adjusted well. I thought moving LeAndre to running back and finally convincing him that that's what he's got to do if we're going to be successful.
Lompoc goes on to win it 36-10, the final score, and they're looking to bounce back and keep everything back on the road for their season.
Lompoc takes on Arroyo Grande next week. We'll be having coverage of that throughout the week and more on how they have bounced back from what last week was. Also tonight was the Bone Marrow Registry, a very successful event for athletic director at Bishop Diego here. And that's Dan Peters and his son, Lundreas, 6 years old, who was diagnosed with leukemia. It takes only 5 minutes to get into the registry, and you can do that anywhere at your doctor's office. Live in Santa Barbara, I'm Dustin Kleeman, KSBY Sports.